Dear participants, welcome to the lecture series on data analysis for social science research. Today's presentation is about data and various measurement scales. What is data? Data are characteristics or information, usually numerical, that are collected through observation. In a more technical sense, data is a set of values of qualitative or quantitative variables about one or more persons or objects. Statistical data are classified on the basis of characteristics possessed by the different groups of units of a universe. The characteristics may be either geographical, chronological, qualitative, according to some attributes, are quantitative in terms of magnitudes. Those characteristics which cannot be quantitatively measured, only their presence or absence in an individual unit can be found out. For example, educational qualification, employment, occupation, etc. We cannot quantitatively express. What we can do is to determine whether an individual's qualification as high school level, higher secondary school level, graduation or post-graduation. Similarly, individual's occupation as unemployed, self-employed, private job or government job, etc. Individual data in the qualitative measurement. You can understand from the table that individuals' data on their educational qualification and occupation in qualitative measurement. What is individual given in the table? It denotes the respondents' number. First respondent, second respondent, third respondent, fourth respondent, and so on. It depends upon the sample size of the study. Whereas educational qualification of individuals, first respondent may be qualified with a high school level, the second respondent may be qualified with a high secondary school level, third respondent may be qualified with a graduation or collegiate level, and the fourth respondent may be qualified with a post-graduation. In case, in continuation of the respondent number, fifth respondent and following respondents may be qualified with graduation or any other category defined by the researcher. Similarly, occupation of individuals qualitative measurement is shown in the next table. So individuals 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Likely occupation, it may be unemployed, self-employed, private job, government job and whatever that may be the categories in the quality. On the other hand, numerical characteristics of individuals are capable in quantitative measurement. For example, age, height, weight, etc. Individuals' age measurement is possible from their date of birth. So the individuals' respondents' numbers are given in that table 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Their age in years is given below 35 years, 48, 54 and 28. Similarly, individuals' height measurement is also possible through the suitable scales for individuals. So height is given in that table in centimeter 154, 165, 170 and 147. Likely, individuals' weight measurement is also possible through weighing machine. So weight for the respondent's weight is given in kilogram in that table 70, 75, 82 and 68. Then understanding different types of data sets is also important in statistics. The data sets are categorized into univariate, bivariate and multivariate based on different variables. A data set consists of only one variable is called univariate data. For example, the first table, age of the individuals are given, age in years like 35, 48, 54 and 28 for the individuals. If a data set consists of two variables is called bivariate data. For example, in the second table, age and height of the individuals are given. Like age in years is given, then height in centimeter it's given as 154, 165, 170, and 147. If a data set consisting of more than two variables is referred to as multivariate data set. In the third table, the variables, namely age, height, and weights, are given for your easy understanding. Then, the types of measurement scales. What is measurement? Measurement is the process of assigning numbers or scores to characteristics or attributes of the objects or people of interest. Data is mainly divided into qualitative data and quantitative data. Further, qualitative data or variable is categorized into nominal and ordinal, whereas quantitative is categorized into interval and ratio. Hence, there are four measurement scales, namely nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio. These are simply ways to categorize the different types of variables and to choose right statistical test, visualization technique, and guide our data analysis. Let us discuss them one by one. Qualitative data is otherwise called as categorical data. If a variable that cannot assume a numerical value but can be classified into two or more non-numeric categories is called qualitative variable or categorical variable. The data collected on such a variable are called qualitative data. There are two types of qualitative variables, namely nominal scales and ordinal scales. What about nominal scales? In the nominal scale, the values are not ordered. Numbers are used to classify, name, or identify individuals or things by groups to which they belong. Just see the example. What is your gender? Male or female? In statistics, number 1 may be used for male, and 2 may be used for female, or any number can be assigned to identify the groups. Similarly, in other examples, what is your educational qualification? The categories given as school level, diploma, graduation, post graduation, and professional qualification. Any number can be assigned based on the choice or purpose. Likely, what is your monthly income? The individual respondents are identified into various groups based on their monthly income. The numerical labels of the categories say nothing about order and cannot be used to add, subtract, multiply, or divide. What about the ordinal scales? In this scale, the values are ordered or ranked. The assignment of numbers to indicate rank or order from the highest to lowest. In a running race, the winner of the race is ranked first, the runner finishing second is assigned the rank 2, and the runner finishing third is assigned the third rank. Just to see the example given here, respondents are asked to rank the risk factors which more affect in online usage. In this given example, the respondents should rank the factors according to their experience or perspectives. Rank of highest risk is assigned 1 and lowest risk is assigned 7 in this question. The ranking does not indicate the quantitative differences between the various ranks, just like the nominal scales. Subtraction, multiplication, and division cannot be used with the ordinal scales. However, statistical analysis of rank order correlation is suitable for this skill. Then, the third is interval scales. The scores obtained on tests and inventories measuring satisfaction, interest, attitude, abilities, perceptions, fall on the interval scale. In this variable, distances between each number and the mean are equal, but a zero point is not known. Look at the diagram as a 5 minutes interval scale. Interval scales are numeric scales in which we know both the order and the exact differences between the values. Another classic example of an interval scale is a Celsius temperature, because the difference between each value is the same. The difference between 60 degree and 50 degree is measurable 10 degrees, as is the difference between 80 degree and 70 degree. Further, Likert's scale like strongly disagree to strongly agree, etc. can be used in this scale. Hence, an interval scale permits us to test scores by computing an average, standard deviation, correlation coefficient, etc. Next, ratio scales. The ratio scales are like interval scales, have equal intervals. Also, an additional property of an exact zero point. Height, weight, and volume may be quantified in this way. It is possible to say that the difference between 20 kg and 30 kg is the same as difference between 30 kg and 40 kg. In addition, we may say that 50 kg is twice as heavy as 25 kg. Also, these variables can be meaningfully added, subtracted, multiplied, and divided. Central tendencies can be measured by mean, median, and mode, and measures of dispersion such as standard deviation and coefficient of variation can also be calculated from the ratio scales. Then comparison of measurement scales for your easy understanding. In a running race, numbers are assigned to players. Just see the picture. If any number is assigned as label, which is nominal scale. In case of ordinal scale, the winner of the race is ranked first. The runner finishing second is assigned the rank 2, and the runner finishing third is assigned the third rank. In the interval scale, the performance interval between the players can be computed. On the other hand, in ratio scale, time to finish the race in seconds from 0 is counted. The winner achieved his performance quickly than others. To summarize, nominal scales are used to assign numbers or labels in a series of values. Ordinal scales provide good information about the order of choices, such as in a customer preference, etc. Interval scales provide us the order of values and the ability to quantify the difference between each other. Finally, ratio scales give us the ultimate order, interval values, the ability to calculate ratios, since a true zero can be defined. Dear participants, the statistical knowledge helps us to use the proper methods to collect the data, employ the correct analysis, and effectively present the results. The above set data sets, data variables, various measurement scales will help us to use right inventories and right statistical techniques to achieve the research objectives. Thanks for your patient listening. If you have subscribed this channel, you will get the video presentation regularly. Let us meet in the next session. All the best.